Network troubleshooting using Wireshark.
All right, so today we're going to cover something really simple and straightforward for anyone there who's new to Wireshark and packet analysis, and that's how to actually perform a data capture in Wireshark. Now, Wireshark has two main functionalities. One is to actually analyze existing capture files, and two is to actually take captures, meaning from a PC or a server to actually allow you to capture the traffic coming in and out of an interface. So to keep things simple, we're going to go through just two things. One is how to select the right interface to capture from and how to start the capture. And two, what is the difference between a capture filter and a display filter? Because when I was learning Wireshark, no one really explained this really well, and I just want to take a minute to explain that. So in our scenario here, let's say that I want to capture all the traffic on this PC. Now, what does that mean? Every computer that is networked has at least one interface which it uses to connect to that network. So let's say, for example, this PC has a physical Ethernet connection to the local router at home, okay? And let's say this PC has a connection to this router here. Now, if I want to do a capture from this PC, right, the first thing I need to know is what interface do I want to capture from? Because some computers will only have one interface, say it's like this interface here. And some computers will have multiple. You know, a computer can have a physical interface, can also have a wireless interface to connect the Wi-Fi, right? But what you're capturing when you do that is all traffic going in and out of that interface, right? When it's not capturing, for example, if I capture on this PC, I'm not going to get the traffic that is destined to this PC. I'm only get the traffic that's going to and from this one up here. And it seems like an obvious thing, but I get this question a lot in the comments of like, well, how do I capture traffic from someone else? Well, this tutorial is not going to show you that. This is just going to show you a scenario where you have access to this PC and you're going to capture traffic from it. So say you're troubleshooting an issue at work or at home from your PC and you need to take the capture so you can analyze it later or send it to someone. This is how you would do it. Okay. So interface selection is number one. Now, this router likely has a connection to the internet. So the traffic you'll see coming out of, say, the physical interface here will be traffic to the router, to the internet. So anything going to the internet. And if this PC is communicating with other PCs on the network, you'll see that as well. Okay, so that's the first point I want to make. So we're over here in Wireshark now, and you'll realize really quickly why I mentioned the importance of selecting the right interface. The PC I'm doing this video from has multiple interfaces, including looks like four Ethernet connections, three local area connections, an Ethernet connection. It's got a Bluetooth adapter on there, and it's got an adapter for loopback, which is a kind of more advanced topic. Now, I know for a fact that my computer is connected via Ethernet cable to the router, right? I like to connect over Ethernet via Wi-Fi. So I know from before this video that that's the case. If you didn't know that was the case, there's a couple of ways that you can figure that out. The first and probably the most easiest way is that Wireshark has this little traffic graph here that shows you the status of how much traffic is going in and out of that interface at any given time, right? So if I wanted to say, figure out, okay, I got some traffic here and I got traffic here. Which one of these is actually the one that is generating the traffic for me? What I can do is run a like download, like I go to the internet and download some traffic, and you'll see that the graph starts to pick up. For now, I know that this is Ethernet, but there's a couple of ways that you can do that. Worst case scenario, do trial and error and capture from multiples. You could also do a shift select and capture multiple interfaces at once. This is only really useful if you're actually using those interfaces. In my scenario, I'm not actually using Bluetooth, and these connections here are all logical interfaces, which is a more advanced topic, but they're not really used. So the only one that actually sends data in and out right now is this Ethernet adapter. So the first step, select the interface that you want to capture traffic from. It's simple enough. The second thing is, and I'm actually going to bleed into my second point about capture filters and display filters, is this thing up here called a capture filter. Now, before I get to that, what I'm going to do is I'm not going to do anything else. I'm going to select Ethernet. I'm going to hit go, the shark icon. And right away, what I'm going to see is a whole bunch of traffic. Even if I'm not actually doing anything on the internet, even if I'm not downloading or playing games or whatever, my computer is always in constant communication. Any computer is in this modern age with internet services, with things like Microsoft, with things like Google. There's lots and lots of background processes on your machine that are connecting to the web. And that's what's going on here, right? I also have things like a webcam running on this server, all that kind of stuff. So this is your first indication that you got something right if you start seeing traffic come in like this, right? I'm going to pause it. I'm going to stop. And this has stopped all traffic or all captures or traffic being captured. This hasn't stopped traffic to my server, right? Traffic is still going on. I just don't want to capture any more of it into a file. And if I want to, I can go through now and just verify, okay, well, my IP address, I know 10.0.10.43. That sounds about right. What I can do is open up a command prompt. Let's just move it over here and do a ipconfig. And I can tell that 10.0.10.43 is indeed the IP address of my adapter. And I can actually make sure it's the Ethernet adapter. So I'm on the right track. This kind of capture is known as a wide open capture. A wide open capture is a capture where you want all traffic coming in and out of the server to be captured into this file, okay? Whether it's IPv4, IPv6, whether it's TCP or UDP, regardless of the protocol, everything coming in and out is going to be captured. Now, this is a really good technique when, say, you're investigating an issue and you really don't know where the issue is. You don't know what port the issue is with, like what protocol. You don't know what application it's with. You don't know much about the details. You just know there's some kind of network issue or suspected network issue. So capturing wide open allows you to do things like, you know, I'm going to analyze all the conversations. Let's poke in and you can see, you know, things like, oh, wow, there's a lot of packets going to this IP. What is that about? It's more of an investigative mode. Now, the downside of doing a wide open capture, give me a sec while I fix my screens. The downside is that the file size can be huge because ultimately you're not stopping any of the traffic from the door. You're laying it all in. So if I was doing this, say, on a file server that's like actively providing a lot of downloads to users, this file would fill up, you know, in maybe a few minutes, maybe a few seconds if it's a really busy server, okay? So wide open is really good if you can do it. Remember that in Wireshark, if the file gets over, I would say 400 to 500 megabytes, even on a good computer, Wireshark is going to have a lot of difficulty actually displaying it and analyzing it. So you want to make sure your file size doesn't get too huge. So that takes me to the second piece of this, which is how to use a capture filter. Now I'm back to the Wireshark launch screen, and I'm going to show you now how to do a capture filter. Now, as I mentioned, sometimes you have a scenario where you really want to filter down and only capture traffic of interest, like traffic as part of an investigation. And that's really, for the most part, to preserve file size. To do that, you use a capture filter, which effectively says, I only want to capture the traffic that matches this filter. The benefit, like I mentioned, is you can reduce file size. The downside is that all that other traffic that's going in and out of the server at this time, you're going to miss. And you need to do another capture later in order to get that that's wide open. So you may need to figure out what's appropriate for the scenario. But the capture filter syntax is pretty simple. If you need to, Wireshark.org has a great reference for this. You could even use ChatGPT and ask it, how do I filter traffic in Wireshark for certain things with a capture filter? But as a simple example, I could do something like UDP port 53. Now, for those of you who know, UDP port 53 is DNS. So what I'm telling Wireshark is that I only want to see the DNS traffic coming in and out on my computer. And I'm going to hit enter. And right away, you can tell the volume of packets that I'm actually capturing in this file is much less than before. And in fact, we can confirm that this is all DNS because Wireshark is telling us it's DNS. Okay, so if you're doing an investigation and you know for certain, like say for example, you're having an issue with your DNS server and you know for certain that the issue is a DNS protocol issue, then you could use a capture filter, run this capture, and actually run it for a lot longer than if you were capturing DNS plus everything else on the machine, right? Some additional examples. Let's just close this out. Do one more example with you. Let's say TCP port 443. That's HTTPS or TLS. And same thing. Now we switch from DNS to TLS and TCP. If you want it, you can just pick a packet and confirm that in this case, the destination port's 443. But that's effectively it, right? You filter down to just what you need, and that way you keep the file size at a reasonable size, or at least less large than it would be if you did a wide open, okay? My preference, especially when I'm troubleshooting, let me just pull up my diagram one more time. My preference is if I'm starting an investigation from scratch, and I don't know anything about the network or about what's going on or what's causing something, I start with a wide open capture. Capture everything coming out of this pipe, okay? What I can do though is put limits on the file size, or later on after I've downloaded the file, I can actually cut it up, which I'll do a video on that later. But do a wide open and then poke around, look at all the conversations, look at what's going on. And then once I know what the fault domain is, like what's actually at stake, like say it is a DNS problem, or say it's a problem connecting to the internet on port 80, right? On a certain application. Then I would then implement a capture filter, capture again, and then let it run for a longer time so I have more data. That's it for this video. If you have any questions about Wireshark or networking, feel free to post it in the comments. We can chat about it there, or you can always send me the capture file to take a look at. I have a Dropbox that I'll send you to send the file. I've also got a Discord server now, so you can check it out that channel and join to do the same. Post questions about networking, issues you're working on at work, etc. And as always, please like and subscribe to support the channel. Until next time.